What's up, guys? It's Ophidian here. I'm just trying to let you guys know I do know about optimal combos, okay? I just want to tell you, this video is primarily going to be about combos that you wouldn't drop in a match. Not all the optimal combos will be present, but pretty much right next to it, 2% underneath, or some of the optimals will be here. I just want to give you guys the combos that are going to work.
Fight.
So we're going to start off with the openers here. These are moves that people will get hit by. Down three, an exceptional opener for Reptile. You're going to open up a lot of hit advantage off of this string. It's a low that's 7 frames, 13 hit advantage. Pretty super safe on block, negative 3. You can press it a lot. Back 3, a low, so it's a mix up. 15 frame startup, so unreactable. Decent hit advantage, also super safe. Back 2, your overhead, it's plus. The startup's 11 frames, that's super fast. You see the hit advantage is ridiculous. Several setup options and combos later to come. So I'm going to break down the mix up here real quick. I'm just going to put them on a block so you can see like a low block. Back 2 is an overhead, meaning if they're blocking low, that's going to open them up. See, back 3 being a low, they block it correctly. So that's the mix up. Overhead or low, here's a nice little convert out of that. The thing is, if the opponent was standing and blocking and you needed to get lows, which primarily they will be standing against Reptile because 4-4-1. 4-4-1-2 is the string that you're going to do more than anything else. You're going to press it to punish. You're going to press it for your pressure because it's super safe. It's a great string to stutter. Look, even 4-4-1 by itself, safe as well. I think even 4-4 is safe. Pretty safe, let me see. Yeah, negative 5, so even by itself. It's a great startup. It's just something that you really have to use a lot as Reptile. It's got decent range on it. The second part of it is an overhead for 4-4-1, so if you mix the slide in here, it'll create the low option, and that's like one of the best mix-ups that you have. I know it seems crazy because, like, what a nut, that slide is punishable if they do block the low. It's just that you have to condition for 4-4-1. Then you'll open your overheads up, because Reptile gets a lot of damage off of overheads, of course, and people are going to want to block high. So as you approach, just make sure you trick them. It works. Trust me, it works. It works. I've done it in tournament. I've done it offline several times. It's something that I know it seems crazy, but trust me, it works. Another opener would be 4-2. It's the other thing that you would want to say anything about because the range is so good. At max range, you're going to be playing footsies like from basically a huge space around here. Okay, next let's go over conversions, guys. It's going to be easy, right? Thing is, you're going to open people up with down three, right? And you're going to need to figure out what to do off that hit advantage, right? 13 hit advantage. You need to figure out, do you want to start pressure here? Do you want to go for an overhead? What do you want to do? Go for a low, back three, whatever it may be, you're going to need to convert, right? So back 3-4 is generally a good string to choose because back three on its own is 15 frames to start up. Back 3-4, safe as well, negative 7, unless for some reason you're blocking against Jason or Goro. When they block low, they can glitch out back 3-4 sometimes. Anyway, it can go into this fast force ball with meter burn, and that frame data is completely wrong. It's not safe to do back 3 into meter burn fast force ball, but There's definitely some wrong frame data there, because it's safer than you would think. It's less punishable than you would think. People will go to try to punish it all the time and they won't be able to. And I'll show you why. Because look, see, like when the reversal is something like that and they're still not getting it out, there's something wrong, obviously, the frame data. There is a gap in between back three into it. So of course, if they were like, you know, option selecting their armor or whatever, then you'll get hit up by that. But it's still a great option because you can get a good amount of damage off the conversion of back three meter burn fast force ball. And like most of the time, it's not getting punished or anything is being done about it, you know. So there's one little conversion off back three meter burn. If you want to keep them on that side, you can also switch sides if you'd like. It's real easy to do so, just kind of retime how you do the NJP. Real easy again, you know, just to keep them on the same side, you can do it like this. I'm going to go through all the conversions in this little section here, so I'm going to show each one of the really good openers and how to convert off of them and how to convert in the corner. For back 3-4, you pretty much just let it rock. That's what you do in the corner for it, meterless. With meter, you'd want to do something like this if you want to get some consistent damage. It's real easy to do that. I know you can get down three slides out of stuff like that, but I'm not going to show those for this particular video just because this is for somebody who's like getting into the game but wants to be as good as top level reptile players. You know, I want to show you guys how to do it fast. So you can run up and get a 4-4-1 convert, but it's just something you really got to be watching for. It's kind of hard to do online, of course, because the lag and whatever. Most of the time, say you didn't have meter, you couldn't run up and do anything. You got to do 4-2-1 and then grab. With 4-2-1 and grab, you're going to get a hard knockdown, which is great. But also, you get to switch sides because it lasts long enough. A lot of people know that little detail because most people are used to waking up in reverse against reptile players that do that. So sometimes do it, sometimes don't. That's a conversion for one bar there. Let's see, let's get him on the right side. Let's get him in the corner here. Right, guys, I want to show you guys the back two simple convert, meterless. You get 32 like that. If you did, for whatever reason, you want to get the back two further away, and you're going to convert, and you have time to jump, then you can get that jump four in the air. And that helps to increase the damage just a little bit like that. Most of the time, you'll go for something like this, where you'll want to use your meter to get up to at least 37. There's also plenty of options for more meter use. Like if you wanted to spend two bars in Nimble, you can get a clean 58. It's super easy to do. Just, you know, watch that a couple times. Practice that for two bar conversions off of back two in the corner. Let's see, what else do we got? I'll show you guys. So say you guys were back in the middle, towards the center of the screen, and you're going to get 4-4. That's one of the most common openers. It's like what you use to punish with. It's kind of what you use to start pressure most of the time. You stutter it with 4-4-1, 4-4-1-2. You do a lot. It's safe. Sometimes you cancel into your specials after that, whatever. It's something you need to know. Meterless, this is one of the best ways to convert off of it. If you do that, then that can save you a lot of meter. You're not, the thing I want to mention is you're not going to want to spin bar if the opponent has bar, because they'll be able to break. So reptile needing his meter and being a very meter dependent character, you're going to have to pay attention to the opponent's bar. You don't want to have these opportunities where you could have gotten 50 and you only got 25%, because maybe next time your meter is more important than that. So be sure to save it.
Wait, I put an overhead comment.
Use it whenever they don't have meter. If you see, okay, 4-4-1-2, I have meter, they don't, I'm going to convert. Go ahead and go for these 50% combos that are rather easy to do. And they just kind of depend on like the distance from the corner. So when you're this distance from the corner, you can get this easy 50%, you know, this combo so easy. You just have to pay attention to their meter, because if they have two bars or if they're close to two bars, then you may not want to spend your bar right away. And also pay attention to the distance. This is a little bit closer. If you're a little closer, you would want to do this conversion. You also get 50 super easy from this one. And let's say that you were a little bit closer than that even. You don't even need a dash. If you got this, you could just do several spits, and then that allows you to still get 50%. So let's talk about if you're in the corner already. You can get 54 out of this, of course, the optimal, but this is an easy, do several spits to get 52%, builds plenty of meter, it's a great combo. That's what you would want to do out of 4-4 in the corner if you spent one bar. Now, the thing is, this combo is distance specific. Say you were this far away from the corner and you needed to figure out, well, okay, how am I going to maximize my damage? Well, you can get 1, 2, 3 dashes, and then you'll still get close to 50%. It's like, okay, so it's 47%. That's the bread and butter. It's super easy to do. You just kind of, you'll feel it out. Like, you'll know the distance that you are from the corner. If you were completely, like, say you're over here, you're almost like the max distance away, you would want to do something like this, because you can utilize as many dashes, and then you can still end with 4-4-1-2 slide to get 45%. And that's like full screen, corner carry, blah, 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 right? It's a good, that is a good combo to know. Another thing I want to tell you guys, like from the center, let's talk about another opener that's going to happen a lot, 4-2-1, because of the footsies. Meterless, you'll want to just do that. It's hard knockdown, 4-2-1, grab. It's an easy, you know, damage type thing. Four, two, one with meter, you'll want to just go ahead and spend it. Get your 33%. It's got pretty decent quarter carry. Also, with 4-2-1, if you think that for whatever reason you're close enough to the corner where you can get a nimble combo to work, it would only be like one distance that I would say is really worth it, and that's right around here where you can get that 51%. And it's still pretty easy because you can catch that slide. Say you are in the corner and you wanted to spend some meter, you can get a quick, smooth 40%. I mean, no problem at all from one bar. So that's good to know too. 4-2-1 itself with nimble added, you're able to get a squeeze, just, you know, a little bit more damage out of things. You can get 60% with two bars, so if that situation presented itself, that's great. Know the opponent will a lot of the times have two bars. 4-2-1 acid spits, like shown earlier. Careful about it, will whiff sometimes. Okay, so getting into pressure. Pressure typically means the buttons are pressing while the opponent is blocking. As in, they're blocking correctly, low blocks for low attacks, standing block for overheads and jump ins, that sort of thing. Some of the strings to mention here that aren't openers that I didn't already mention would be back one down four, especially because it's confusing to most opponents. They so often think about 4-4-1. 4-4-1-2 is so commonly used that back one down four throws people off since the second hit is a low. And with 4-4-1, the second hit is an overhead. So of course, that's tricky for a certain amount of time, but there are limits to it. Unless you canceled back one down four into a slide, that's the only way there's no gap in between what you're about to do next. So they can option select if they choose to. I guess if, you know, they'd like. Most of the time it gets blocked. You got to respect people these days and do back one down four into claw. But if they are reversing it, then just be sure to block. You can punish. It's still safe, so back one down four is just still such a great string to use. It's really tricky, but it's worth it because, I mean, it's just being as safe as it is and kind of, you know, that elusive, that's all about Reptile. You know, that's what Reptile's like. He's also got 2-1, standing one. Both of these are plus 2. So with these moves here, it's funny because you can do 4-4-1, or you can do things like, you know, 2-1 into down 3, whatever it may be. All these different things I've just shown, it's going to confuse people. Stuttering is what Reptile's about. And of course, from earlier, you know, 4-4-1 or 4-4 slide. That's something that in pressure, it's going to be so dangerous. But it's, you know, it's risky, but it's worth trying. You're going to condition so many times for 4-4-1-2 claw that you're going to be able to sometimes get 4-4-1-2 slow meter burn force balls out. Or even go into nimble setups, which this is kind of like a, I'm calling it a pressure setup. It's more of like a nimble gimmick because you're not really plus enough off anything to cancel into basilisk mode and go into stuff. But most of the time people respect and they're not poking, or if they are pressing a button, they're pressing it too late. Another string, 2-1-2-4. It's pretty good. The thing about it is, when you do 2-1-2, pretty much people option selecting the 2-1 if they're already doing that. 2-1-2-4 doesn't really make that much of a difference. It's just a cool thing to throw in there sometimes. Things like this, back one down, I mean back one, back two. 2-1 into pressure, of course. 4-4 slide, just kind of going over the motions again. These are great pressure tools. You kind of just have to see what you can get away with, though, against the opponent, because everybody's different. Certain people will get locked down to pressure. Other people love to press buttons, so you got to treat them differently. And then, of course, don't ever forget to throw. If someone's blocking too much, please try to throw left or right. It's going to be hard for them to deal with. So, yeah, just keep all these pressure strings. Also, 1-4. It's kind of nice to see it sometimes. If you do it and hit them with it, it stops the kind of the sequence because they just get knocked down hard. But it's kind of cool because people aren't used to seeing that one, so you can stutter it as if it's plus, even though it's just slightly negative. Slightly negative and plus, basically the same thing in MKX, right? Because that's the moment where you got to make decisions. You can do these pretty fluently. You can make that back one into the back two so that they're so used to back one down four. Pretty much there's just little things like this that you gotta do. And then once you open them up, you'll be able to convert. I know I'm gonna have to talk a little bit more extensively about the conversions for back one down four. So I'll just go into that now. Back one down four, of course, has a gap after back one down four if you special cancel into claw, dash, force ball, which is what you're gonna want to try that most of the time. You could do back one down four slide. There's no gap there, but it's unsafe, so that's, you know, really nutty to try to even do that. Most of the time you just want to stay off of being safe and then try to punish. But if you feel like you can catch somebody with it, try to cancel into the fast force ball and get a little conversion like this. That's like the mid-screen conversion, has plenty of corner carry. You don't have to worry about using any meter. So it's just a great meterless damage combo that you'll want to do every time. And now if you are in the corner and you want to keep it one bar, nimble, it's easy, super easy to get almost 50% just like this. I know you can get 50%, but that's just the combo I like to do because it's super simple. Say you were in the corner and you do back one down four. An easy, I think this is like 52, so 52%. Now let's get into setups. I know I've already done several videos on setups before. Basically what setups are, it's like when you knock the opponent down and you go for some sort of oki that may or may not be real. Also, setups can be done in pressure. Frame traps kind of relate to things like that. Say drones were out or something like that. I don't know. Reptile's pressure is pretty simple, kind of gimmicky, but the setups and pressure that you use kind of looks like this. Especially for Nimble, because you want to play Nimble. There's really no reason to play any of the other variations at this point. It's 2017. Everyone knows Nimble Reptile's the way to go. That's how you squeeze the damage. It's just great. Here's a setup here that I'll show you more of later.
Yo, I figured I would do it for you guys since it's the weekend. See this setup right here? For some reason, that works. And I just want to show you a couple of converts out of that, just because it's crazy stupid. It's stuff like this. It works, trust me. Like that jump four right there, somebody would cross their wake up and for some reason press buttons and got hit. From here on out, just imagine that I do a jump four and I would be plus and then go for a mix up, like back three, for example. You could also go for overhead, of course, right after that. There is a gap after you jump four. Of course, there's going to be a gap for the next thing, but with plus and with Nimble being on, most people are just going to chill. They're just going to let you go for pressure. So you could do something like that for the overhead. You could do forward four slide if you wanted to, like this, and that would make it to where they're just going to really guess wrong, basically. It's a huge risk for you, but you could go with full string like this and still get a pretty decent convert, so not too bad, right? I mean, that's something that is happening quite frequently.
So yeah, just to kind of see certain things like the pressure setups in reality. See, Dark 55 chose to press a button, of course, and even here, standing four into the forward four, pressing buttons, it's too late. You can get really easy conversions out of stuff like that. It's awesome. Mainly what this section is going to be about, conversions part three, is just that situation in particular. Say you do get into Basilisk mode and you're in the opponent's face. You're going to have to choose what to do at that point. Are you going to go for more pressure? Are you going to try to go for a mix-up? You know, are you going to maybe just try down three to get a whole lot of hit advantage and, I don't know, jump or... maybe you want to get different positioning. Who knows? You can do things like this. This is the back three. Say, for back three, say you were like a little bit further out. I just wanted to show you. You can still get 40%. Okay, so now I'm going to show you the overhead. I'm just going to put her on the low block. Super easy. Yeah, that way you can kind of just squeeze an easy conversion out of that. Also, say you just are going to go into 4-4-1-2. 4-4-1-2, you can just repeat it. Get that little standing one in there. Nice 32%. I guess if you were feeling really frisky and you wanted to do 4-4 slide like that, you can get a conversion that's great. I mean, close to the corner, you're going to get some decent damage. It's going to vary, you know, your distance from the corner, of course. But if you wanted to try something like that, it can be done. Sometimes, you know, something that crazy could actually work. Another thing is these setups or conversions off these types of setups in the corner are really important for Nimble. You can get 50%, of course. That's something, you know, Reptile's going to do a whole lot of damage in the corner, like most characters are. He's got crazy corner carry. I mean, with these conversions, you can do pretty much anything you want with them. You can end them with setups, you can carry, you can convert for damage. It's really up to you. A lot of times I like to just go ahead and convert for the damage on these, but I see plenty of Reptile players get some success off of dropping certain combos, especially mid-screen early, to put force balls out and establish more pressure. Make sure you know all of these conversions. These are very simple ones. They're something that a Nimble Reptile player really needs to make sure they know and get down, because it sucks to see those opportunities where something could have been done, a combo of, you know, huge damage that's really not that hard, and they went for the optimal thing and they lost it, or maybe they didn't know what to do and then they lost it. So just watch this video several times, see if you can get used to some of these conversions. I've gotten used to them. They're super easy for me to do. I can do them all the first try. So yeah, with practice makes perfect, of course. And that's about it, guys. To end it, I'm going to show you guys a little highlight thing that looks funny. NJ kicks. Ayo. That's pretty hilarious, right? Yeah. Oh. You tried to down one out of that. Here's a little setup for you, Brant. Pig of the Hut. I got you, bro. Yeah, see, you can't even input the wake up the other way. It won't work.
Yup.
It's your boy. Hope you guys enjoyed this guide, and I will see you in Injustice 2.